ready to do some painting. Hope you all can join me. I'm going to paint an Easter chick pulling an egg cart with eggs inside. Let's see who's going to join. See if it, get it to join me there, Harry. Nobody's come on yet. But I'm going to paint anyway, even if you're not joining me. Maybe somebody will come on. You can rewatch it later anyway. If that's the good thing. And Mary is uploading everything to YouTube. So all of these videos will be available for you to see at any given time. Debbie's there. Oh, hi, Debbie. Debbie always paints with me every Sunday night. Hi, Debbie. Glad you're with us. Carrie's fixing it for me so that, and I've got a stand so maybe I can see the comments a little bit easier, because I haven't been good at responding to the comments. I'm still learning how to do these videos. So
Ashley's there.
So Ashley is there. Good. Good to see you, Ashley. I know you've been cutting stuff. Oh yeah, I can see it here from here.
So what you might have to do is touch it every see how it went away.
Okay. Yeah. So I just have to touch it, so then I can see it. Okay. Pam Dunn is with us. Hi, Pam.
There's Mary.
And Mary's here. Good. Okay. Happy Sunday. I'll talk to you about our chick. This is one of the biggest ones that we have painted, or that I have painted anyway. I think maybe Mary and Ashley have painted bigger ones because they have a bigger space to work. And if we do many more bigger ones like this, I'm going to have to get a bigger table because I use this little 4-foot folding table that I got at Walmart. But I may have to get a 6-foot table. Let's look at this sucker, how big it is. I mean, this chick, the chick itself is so cute. And then it's pulling this egg cart. I'll pull that over like that. And it's got eggs in the back of it. So it is a really cute thing to paint. So I'm going to talk first about the colors that I used. And several people had asked about the brushes. So I'll try to tell you during the... I got my brushes that I'm using ahead of time, so I'll talk to you about those too. But my chick is light yellow, number 13. And, of course, then I shaded the chick with shading yellow, which is number 14. All of this greenery down at the bottom, I painted the whole thing solid with Christmas green. Which is number 11. So the whole bottom is with Christmas green. Then I came back in with lime green, number 10, to give some highlights and some lighter grassy areas. So my green is number 10 and number 11, Christmas green. And then I outlined with dark green, number 12. So that's what all the greens were. My flowers were white, which is, where's my white? Oh, here's my white. White is number 35. I always use number 35. Of course, I outlined with black, which is number 37. You'd think by now I'd know these numbers by heart, but I don't. Because I used the black to outline. My cart itself, I used reindeer brown, number 32, for the wood of the cart. And then I shaded with nutmeg, which is number 33. So I shaded, and then of course I used my black on the wood. The feet, I used asterisk orange, number 18. For his feet and for the beak on the bird. And then I shaded it with red orange. Don't think I pulled my red orange out. I'll have to grab it. The center of my flowers was shading pink, number 26. Then over here at my egg, I don't want to spill my water, but I'm going to shift this down a little bit. The egg itself was white and sky blue, number one. This is such a pretty blue color. I really like this blue color. So number one and my white. Then my eggs themselves, the base coat was seafoam green, which was number 8 for the base coat of this egg. And the base coat of the center egg was coral, number 15. And then the base coat of my third egg was number 25, light pink. Then for my details, I used shading purple, which is number, it's too far away on my cart. I used shading purple for the details. I used yellow again on this one, and I used teal. And I'm the mixture that I had of light pink and shading pink together for my stripes on this one. So those are the colors that I've used on this. Of course, you know, you can use any color you want. These eggs can be any color that you want to do. The same thing with the eggshell here that's the cart. I told you last week, blue is my favorite color, that's my go-to color. So I thought a light sky blue and making it pastel, that'll make it pop in the yard. The brushes, after I base coated, and I base coat with a big brush. I base coat with a brush. I don't base coat with a roller. Mainly, I just don't have place to store it, so I base coat with a brush. And I use these big number 20s, these big flat number 20s. Is what I use to base coat with. I can put a lot of paint down. I almost always use two colors. The yellow, after my two colors, it still looked a little splotchy to me, so I put a third coat of the yellow. But the white didn't need a third coat, and my light blue, the other two coats was enough. The green, I just put one coat of the Christmas green down because I knew I was going to come on top of it with other colors. This is a number 6 flat, and I use it a lot. I used it for the wood because it was exactly the same size as the wood. It's probably a half inch brush. It's a number 14 flat, but it's exactly the same size as the wood. So I could come down and stay right inside those CNC lines. I use an angled brush. I like this angled brush because, you see the angle on there? Because I can make it narrow and then push it down flat to get it wider. So I like using an angled. Then I like these rounds, and I use, this one is a 10, this one is an 8, I've got another 10. I use those for going around the outline of my shading. They make a really nice line to go around the shading. They're just the right size for the kind of shading that I like to do. Plus, you can get a little tip if you want to do a little highlight on there. Then I have my script liners. I have my script liner that I got at the store, and then I have another script liner that's one size smaller. And then I have a real tiny one that I use. And this one is like a 2. Yeah, this one is like a 2. So those are kind of the brushes that I use. I use this script liner when I've got lots to do. I use it for all my black. If I'm just doing a little bit, I'll use the smaller one because the bristles are not quite as long and it doesn't load up quite as much. But the script liner like this is the one that I use most of the time. Okay, so and the last thing I'm going to tell you is I glittered the crown. I wanted the crown to be glittery, so I took some of my reindeer brown and I took some of my yellow and I mixed them together for my base coat, and then I put my glitter, and unfortunately, I didn't have any gold glitter from the store left over from Christmas. I had red, and I had white, and I had green, but I didn't have any gold. So I had to go scratch through all of my old art supplies, and I found a jumbo glitter that I got at Michael's for $2.99, but it was gold, and it's real big. So what I had to do to get that glitter to adhere is I had to use some of my poly, my coating poly, and I covered with the coating poly, and then I put my glitter on there, and I let that dry I have not put a top coat on there yet because I don't think it's still good and dry because I had to scramble. I had to paint all afternoon to get this done. I had a really busy week, and so I didn't get a lot of painting done in the middle of the week. So I had to really scramble, and I had to use my hair dryer to dry so that it would dry. I didn't put my hand in it. But this is a fun one to paint, but it's big. I'll tell you that. It's big. So I'm going to move it out of the way, and I'm going to put my other one down that's just been base coated. When you buy these, the stake is on the back because it is this bigger stake, because this is too big for the cold rolled steel. See, we have the cold rolled steel ones, and you can see the difference in the size. And this piece is just too big to have these to go in the yard. So you had to have the bigger stakes. So I took them off the back because it's just too hard to work with to have these on there. So the screws and the nuts are still on the back. All right, the first thing I'm going to do, and I'm going to turn this around to get my green, and I'm going to work on the green. So I've already got this base coated, and you're going to have to watch me upside down. I'm sorry, I can't. This is too big and too far. So I'm going to take, I've already got the green down, and I'm going to take my lime green. Let's see if we have any questions. Oh, 28 is shading purple, yeah. Okay. Dolores, I'm glad you're with us tonight. Okay. So I've got my lime green, and I'm going to take this mop brush that is probably, it's a size 8. You can use an 8 or a 10. And I'm just going to come in, and I'm going to put lots of green right along the edge of my wheel, kind of following some of those grass lines that are already there. And then I'm coming on this side, and I've got my C and C lines cut there. So I have those to follow. You probably can't see those, but I'm following those lines. So I'm just coming down the center of that and filling in with this line. And this is probably going to need a second coat as it dries. Put it a little heavier. But I want it to look a little sketchy, I guess you'd say, so that it'll look light and dark in coloring. And I'm going to come up here. My wheel is squishing that grass out. So I'm going to put some little marks up here on my wheel, inside my wheel. Now those CNC lines are not there, but I'm just adding some little grass lines under that wheel. Now I'm going to come over here to this wheel. I'm going to do the same thing. I've got some CNC lines here. And then there's some right down here that are a little tuft of grass that are here in the front. I'm just following those lines. And as big as this is, I have to shift it from time to time as I'm working on it. Like I said, I think I need to invest in a 6-foot table. We're going to do too many bigger ones because I really like, I think this is going to show up so good in the yard. It's going to be a real statement piece. It's going to be as big as some of our Christmas pieces. by his foot. And I'm going to come around his foot and get mostly green in, of this lighter green. Because his foot, he's mashing that grass down. And I didn't put any in this wheel. But I'm going to put some grass up inside that wheel where it's squishing around. Grass is being pushed down. Okay, now that gets all of that teal, I mean all of this lime green in, and it's going to have to dry just a little bit. I'm coming back and just adding a second right on top to get it a little darker, just down the center of each one of those. Because this dries pretty quickly, especially indoors. So I've got my lime on there, and I let that dry. I wash this brush out a little bit because I like that brush, and I'll probably use it again. And Carrie set this phone over here up so that, hi Patty Dicker, I'm glad you're with us tonight. Linda's there. Linda, I'm going to get you painting sometime. You're going to have to get a blank and paint with us. I know you watch, but you're going to have to paint too. All right, while this is drying, I'm going to come up to my egg. I'm going to turn it upside down. I'm going to come around to my egg. And I'm going to do some shading on my egg. I used medium blue before. But after thinking about it, my light blue, my sky blue, it's really a better shading to use the teal than the medium blue that I used. You can see that the color family of these works much better than these. Now I used this on the other one, but I don't want to use it now. I'm going to use this teal because I think it's better color family. And sometimes when you're painting, you make one choice and you think it was a good one, and then later you think, no, I should have done something else, and you can go back and change it. I don't think it was a big boo-boo or something that was I shouldn't have done. It worked out okay, but you learn each time you do something. So I want to use this one for my shading. So I just get this mop brush and come right along the edge of my CNC cut lines. And I'm going to come down around my basket. The wood of the, not a basket, it's my wooden carriage, I guess you'd say, that the egg is on. This design came from a vintage postcard. And I thought the chick with the crown, because we put crowns on so many things today, and I just thought that chick with the crown was just hilarious. And I think the glitter will make it shine in the yard. So it'll have a shadow, that my wheel will make a shadow. So I'm going to do my shading all around my wheel. And while I'm here, I'll just put in some, those highlights. Get that same width of line, I'm flattening my brush out as I push down on it, and that helps get that same width of line. Letting the width of the brush determine how much shading I'm putting on there. And I want those corners pointed like the zigzag. Now, while I've got my teal, I made stripes on my egg, and I used teal and my shading pink. So I'll go ahead and I'll put my stripe on, and I used a small curved stripe at the top. And then I made them wider, left room for my pink. And then I made them come a little wider, graduated stripes, I guess you'd say. I wanted each stripe a little wider than the previous one. Okay. See my distance here and my distance here? They need to be the same. So I need to curve this one up more to get a better distance. And without those CNC lines, that's not on there. You can decorate your eggs, you know, however you wish, because we did not, when we did this pattern, we left the eggs plain, so you can decorate them in any way you choose. Okay, my white is shaded with my light blue, and I forgot to tell you that, which is number two. So I'll go ahead and shade my light blue. I'll just wash out that same brush because I still was using blue colors, so it won't have to be cleaned, you know, real good. and you could use beard blue to shade your egg. A lot of times with white we do, but I thought this sky blue was just enough that you got a little shading, but it didn't take away from the white. And I'm going to outline all of my CNC cut lines with black because I think it makes it pop. So if I get under or over that line just a little bit, it won't matter because my black will cover it up. Now, while I'm up here, I used yellow for polka dots on my coral egg. So I'll go ahead and put those on there. And you could use one of the pounce foam brushes if you want. I didn't want them quite that big. It wouldn't matter how big the polka dots you put on there are. But I just use this number 6 round and just paint them in. Because I'm not going to put a lot of polka dots. I'm letting quite a bit of paint kind of mound up so I don't have to do a second coat on. I shaded this coral color with my asterisk orange. So I'm going to come in here. Probably should have done that before I put the polka dots on, but I didn't get the polka dots right on the edge, so it's. And this is not a drastic shading because this asterisk orange is the same color family and it's almost the same tone. Okay. I'm going to get my shading yellow for my chip. And I'm going to get this bigger brush. This one is about a 9 or a 10. And I'm going to shade my little cheeky here with shading yellow. use a little lighter pressure along the edge of my wood because I don't want that line quite as wide as the one on my outside edges. So I just use a little bit lighter pressure. And this is his wing. His back. Now I want him to have some tail feathers. So I'm going to come up here. Come around here for some tail feathers. I want those wings to have extra feathers. I want him to have a little bit of tummy in here. A little bit across his back. A little bit down his head here. Okay, that's good for right now. While that has an orange color to it, so I'll come down and get my shading pink and put the center of my flowers. You could make them sunflowers if you wanted to and make them yellow and with a brown center. That would be real good. I wanted kind of Gerber daisies like. I wanted the white to pop. So now I'm going to got my pink brush out. So I'm going to come back over to this egg. And I'm going to put my, let's see, I started pink and then I did another pink here. And then a wider one. Shade with my pink. I want this one to dip down just a little bit more. I may have to come back and put a second coat on that one. Get those stripes in. Okay. And my seafoam egg, I used, I have to reach I used light purple and shading purple on that seafoam egg. Which are number 28 and number 27. So, I did some scallops. Just let my brush curve. Or if you want to call it a snake. Like two passes. And then skip down a little bit. Try to echo that same shape. And then one more time. And that got my light purple. I didn't put much light purple. I used a lot more of the shading purple. So then I came along the edge and I didn't let it dry. I let it blend together. Did some dots or some circles here at the top. Just a semicircle across the top. So my egg needs to dry. I'm going to hit it with my hair dryer a little bit. Move this down here and I'm going to work on my wheels a little bit. And I'm going to get my nutmeg. All those over out of the way. And I like that shorter script liner I was using, so I'm going to get it. It's a nice script liner, but it's not quite as long. It's maybe a fourth of an inch shorter, I don't know if you can see that, than the big script liner that I use. So I'm going to take my nutmeg, and some of my green is still wet right there, and I don't want to mess that up, so I'm going to dry that. Y'all aren't asking any questions tonight. Okay, I've got my nutmeg, and I want to come around the, and that is a little thick. I'm going to add some water to that. sometimes you have to add water. If it's not wanting to flow well, you need to add a little bit of water. If you're not getting a smooth line and it feels like it's dragging, add just a little bit of water. This is my wheel, but it's wood. So I'm going to take, and as I'm doing that, I'm just going to put some little wood grain lines. Some of them light, some of them heavier. Some curve around. So this is a wood. See, I'm doing the top half before I do my bottom half so I don't get my hand in it. And this is nutmeg that I'm going to put some lines in. And here too. And this is the hub of the wheel. And so I want my lines to be kind of circular. Clear on down. This is the shaft that little chick's gonna hold. Just little squiggly lines. Some light, some dark. You notice my screw is right there. Just paint right over the top of the screw so that it just disappears. And you've got that CNC cut line to guide you coming around your wheel. Back wheel is done. It's not done, but the nutmeg part is done. Now I've got this one, and it's a smaller wheel. y'all had a good Sunday. You know, my daughter was telling me that I should ask where you all are from, because I guess I assume most of you are from the Pearland area, but maybe some of you are not. So if you would, put if you're, you know, local to Pearland, or if you're watching from somewhere else. Because I know Yard Arts R Us has customers from everywhere. So it could be that some of you are not local, and you're buying the patterns and cutting them out yourself and painting them rather than buying the blanks over at the store or ordering them. So if you would, if you're watching tonight, put where you're from. So I'll know where you're from, and I think that'll be interesting for everybody else to see, you know, where you're from too. Because a lot of you might not know that Ashley lives way north of Mary, yet they work together and run Yard Arts R Us. But what, Ashley, are you an hour and a half away from Pearland? Maybe not that far, but it's a good drive. It's all the way across Houston. Okay, so now all of my brown is finished. And my green is dry. So I'm going to come in with my dark green now. And I'm going to use my bigger shader. Don't need that brown, I'll move it out of the way. Of my dark green. I'm going to go on top of those CNC lines this time. It's like I'm outlining with my dark green. But I'm not trying to, I guess, go exactly on them. If I extend out from them, that's okay too. Because I want this grass to start looking more like grass. So I'm using curved lines coming down the center of it. And come up here inside my wheel with my darker color now. It's a layering effect that you want to get on your grass. There's not any right or wrong way of doing it. You're just kind of adding a darker element into your lighter areas. just think about how grass grows and the individual spikes of grass as they come up. I put them in their kennel so they wouldn't bark. But he's going to it anyway. And I want to outline around my little chick's foot. I'm adding extra green, dark green strokes. So you have extra little braids of grass coming up there. See over here. Adding extra little blades of grass in my dark green background. Okay, so I'll let that dry. Then when I come in with my black outlines and then my white highlights, it really starts coming together. All right, let's see. I'm almost ready for my black. Just pretty close. My chick is about drying ready. So I'm going to take, I've got a little bit, but I'm going to make some more to show you. To outline, you need your black to be thin. So I pour a little in one of these cups. Take some water and I'm going to add some water to it. I want it the consistency of heavy cream, like whipping cream, thicker than milk, but thinner than like a milkshake. I could pour this, but this way I can control kind of how much I'm putting in there. And I'm wanting the water to kind of sit on the top of it, and that way I can tell how much water I'm putting in there. And then I'll start mixing it up until I get that consistency I want. If this isn't enough water, I can always add some more. But that's pretty good right there. I want it like whipping cream. Okay. So for my little chick, the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to do his eye and his beak. Come up and I want to go right in that CNC line for the eye. I'm going right along the edge, right in that line. I already painted white over 3/4 of it. Then I'm going to paint that eyeball in. I'll come back and I'll add a white highlight. And I want him to have a couple little eyelashes here. I'm going to add to it. then on his beak. Outline his beak. There's a line down the center of it. And I'll come back and put a white highlight on that too. Alright, now then I'll start down here at his feet. Have to stretch pretty much. Because I don't want to get my hand in it. So I'm starting at the bottom. Stretching a little too far for me. And see, this part right here was not dry. I can wipe some of it off with my finger, but I'll have to go back in and touch that up because it's not dry enough. And I like to let it dry between coats. That way you don't have as much touch up. This shaft of his wagon that he's and I'm going to add in a little bit of black lines in with my brown ones for that wood. That black really starts making the colors pop. Plus, from a distance in your yard, it really makes it show up. And you got to think, these are going to be out in your yard. So you want them bold, you want to use bright colors, make them show up out in that yard. I hope when you finish painting some of your designs that you post them for us to see. A few people are, but not all of you are posting. And you need to post what you've done. We want to see it because we all like to see each other's work. I'm going to add some his tail feathers here. Okay, so until I do my white highlights, my little bird is done. So I'll come down here and I'll work on one of my flowers. So I want to just outline. And it does not have any CNC lines for the petals. So you'll have to make your own. So if you just come down, come around this curve. This is going to be my first petal. Come up here. So I've got one petal. So now I'll come over here. Let this one come down. Come up. There's another petal. So then I've got my last one. So now I've got four petals in there. This one has a little funny hump right there. So I'll just come around and make that a petal. So now you've got your petals. So you want to put a little veining in those petals. You've got that flower done. It's too wet in here for me to do that flower. So I'm going to come over here and work just a little bit on my wheel so that you can see how I would add my black to my wheel. Get it where my hand's not in it. Someone was talking today, they posted one of their, I think it was the birdhouse, and she was talking about how it was hard to do the lettering and to go in those CNC lines. A lot of times it's, your paint is not thin enough. You need to make sure that your paint is thin enough so that it will fall down in that line, and then you come back over it and it will make a smooth line for you. The bottom of my egg too while I'm doing these spoke lines. See, I'm going to add a little bit of black. completely around that circle. And then I want to put some circular lines with my black so that that hub looks like it's a piece of wood that's cut. Coming right across the top of that screw again. Just act like it's not there. Now I'm going to add some black lines in for my grass. Okay, so that wheel is done. Now while I've got my black, I'm going to come in here. I'm going to come right along my edge. Add some black in with my dark green. Bottom of my egg. So you can see how that wheel turns out. I'm not going to do this wheel right now because it's exactly the same way. What I am going to do is my legs on my chicken. Not chicken yet. It's a little chick. It's not chicken yet. So I'm gonna get my red orange. And I want to clean that brush out because I like that one. I'm gonna use that brush. So I want to outline my legs with this red orange. And it's not going to show up a lot because it's almost the same value as that asterisk orange. But it's going to give a little form to these legs. There's two legs together. You've got a CNC line here. One leg's in front of the other, and you just see the talons or the toes of the front leg. You don't see the back leg. Then I'm going to, they kind of have scales, I guess you would say. So I'm going to do some little horizontal lines across just a few little lines across there. And then I'll emphasize that with the black when I shade it with black. Let me hit this with the dryer and see if I can get it dry enough. I can shade it with the black. We'll see. Hair dryer will speed things up. Tell by touching it, it's not good and dry. You want to reinforce those little lines that we made with the red orange. Then you'll put a white highlight on that also. Now this may be dry enough that I could do my other flower. Veining. Then you have that flower done. So I'll come in and I'll put some black in my grass. some up there. And I don't have it on this side of the grass. Now when that dries, I'll add white highlights. I'm going to pick up my finished one and talk about it just a little bit more. Because I don't think you need to see me outline the egg because it's just straight lines. I put white highlights after I finished my black. I came back in with white. I added little white highlights on the legs, some white highlights in the wings on the chick, and then over here on my eggs, I put a big curved white highlight so that the egg looks three-dimensional. So I put a big curve. I outlined them with black, but I put this big curved white outline. I added some white outlines in my blue, but I, of course, didn't in the white. And then I added just a little bit of white outline in the wood. The white really pops it up, but it needs to be dry. You need to let your black dry before you add your white. So I came across the top of his back, down his cheek, around the wings, on each one of the wings. I added some here for the tail feathers, but that white really pops it up. And then, like I said, for the crown, I coated it with the poly and sprinkled my glitter on it, and then let that dry. When this is good and dry, tomorrow I'll put another coat of poly on this glitter. It's pretty stuck down, but there may be some that aren't completely stuck, and that poly will make it stick. So when you get the light on it outside, it's going to shimmer and shine. You can see that. You probably could outline across the top of this with black if you felt like you needed to, but I think the light hitting it is going to make it shine in the sunshine anyway, and I don't think you're going to need it. But that's the chick pulling his egg cart. He's a big one, but he's lots of fun. And I hope you all have a good time painting it. Let me look and see if there's anybody that has any questions. Debbie's like me. She likes the blue colors. Tiffany, I'm happy that you're watching tonight. It's not letting me have my comments. Mary says she was complaining to Bruce about how many paper towels we go through. Hey, I go to Sam's, and I get the big thing at Sam's because I do, between painting and the dogs, because I have that little 4-pound Maltese who thinks he's a big dog, and he, even though he's been neutered, he still has to mark his territory. And I got so mad at him today because I came in and I had bought a big package of water bottles. and I put them down in the kitchen floor because I was going to put them in the pantry. Part of them I was going to put in the refrigerator, part of them I was going to put in the pantry, so I hadn't opened them up yet. And I'll be if that little sucker didn't go over there and hike his leg on that. So I had to wash all those water bottles, then had to clean the floor, Lysol it, paper towels. So I go through a lot of paper towels too. Carolyn's hoping to make grass just like yours. It makes it pop, doesn't it? But Carolyn, if you saw, it's really easy. It's just slap it on there. There's no right or wrong reason how to do it. So anyway, hope you all had a good time tonight. We'll see you next time. Happy painting. Hope you have a good week. Bye-bye.